some reason we got volts. Hold on. Okay, it's gone. All right. And we're ready to roll. Right here, we're fine. I have to go all the way down. Port Hawksbury Atlantic, Fox Romeo uniform. It's taken off. 29, departure to the west. We're gonna find an opening through the cloud to go home. And I think we're probably gonna have to get down here. We're gonna stay at 2500. The wind is pushing us this way. This is the eastern shore of Nova Scotia, all the way up to Cape Breton. So we're going to follow the coast all the way down to Halifax, and then we're going to cut across and we're going to go to Debert. We've got an hour and a half before our landing time, before those guys set the Hercules up to find us. Hopefully they won't have to. So we're just going to follow the coast, and I'm hoping to find this wreck. I have no idea where it is, but I know it's near the coast, and I know that if it is on our path, we're definitely going to find it. We're going to do a low pass, and then we're going to contact Halifax Terminal in about 20 miles from here, and from there all over to Debert. Now we are pretty much in about 10 miles from the northernmost part of mainland Nova Scotia, excluding Cape Breton, the little fishing village down here. Now from here we're going to go directly west to towards Halifax. This is probably one of the most beautiful areas in Nova Scotia, totally undiscovered. Just gorgeous, and what a great afternoon. And again, I'm looking for that sunken ship. Better view since we're near the water. We're gonna descend down to about 1500, get a better view of the coast. And as we continue towards Halifax, we're passing areas that I have no clue where we at, other than on my GPS. But it's definitely breathtaking. Beautiful. It is choppy, it is bumpy, but that was expected. and we don't want to miss the scenery. Let's see if we can contact Halifax Terminal here, see if we got any luck. How many miles are we back? 60? Okay.
Jazz 852, report 10 loop final, contact the tower now, 118.4.
Alright, welcome.
Air Canada 1833, advise 10 loop final with the tower, contact them now, 118.4, talk to you later.
So we're going to leave the coast, and we are, how many miles? 57 to...
Buckshot, Romeo Uniform, Halifax.
Halifax, Buckshot, Romeo Uniform, go ahead, please.
Buckshot, Romeo Uniform, what altitude will we be doing the coast crawl?
2500 and below.
Buckshot, Romeo Uniform, Roger. Let me know when you're coming up on Shearwater, and before you turn northbound to Debert, please, that you will be using runway 32 at Halifax.
Roger Terminal, we're actually turning direct towards Debert right now, so we're going to stay out of your way.
Uniform, let me know when you have, or actually just outside of Churro, just call that for me, please.
Will do, thanks, Terminal, Fox 11 Uniform. I don't think we could have been...
Georgia 7469, contact Moscow Center now, 124.4.
I don't think we could have been any more... any more center Nova Scotia as we are right now. This is the middle of
our Romeo Uniform. Do you plan to stay at 2,500 feet until in descent through north of Churro into Debert?
Colonel, sure, we can stay. If you have any other ideas, I'm free to do whatever you are comfortable with.
Officer Uniform, I do have traffic helicopter medevac off Halifax International going to New Glasgow. He'll probably be in the same vicinity at the same time. He's planning 1,200 feet, so he'll stay below you as long as you stay at 2,500 feet until Churro. That'll work out fine with him.
Roger, I will stay at 2,500 then until advised by you.
Officer Uniform, Roger, just stay at 2,500 feet until in the vicinity of Churro. That'll work out fine.
Roger that. Buffalo Romeo Uniform, thanks. Yeah, these guys are... this guy's a medevac, they're carrying sick people. They're probably going to pick up someone in, out in, where did he say?
New Glasgow.
They're going to New Glasgow, yeah. So they're 1,200, we're 2,500, so that's fine. They're going to pop underneath us, basically. It's a helicopter. I'll check to see if I see him, I doubt it. Headwinds, about a 25 knot wind. But overall, it was a good flight. We did, we're about close to 3 hours now. By the time we land and everything, and the plane will be about 3 hours. All right, let's get down to 1,200. Let's get down to 1,200 here. 1,200. And we're gonna descend at 400 feet per minute. Cut down to 2,000 RPMs. And we're gonna let the autopilot... we're gonna let the autopilot take control here. Get us down to 1,200.
Your traffic, Fox Romeo Uniform is descending through 2,400 to 1,200, and we're back 7 miles.
We're descending at 500 feet per minute. Autopilot's still on. We got it at 100.
100 knots. We got it at 100 knots. The autopilot is still on. We're now descending through 2,000. And we are 6.5 nautical miles from Debert. We have the airfield in sight. We know that there is one guy that just landed, so there should be no more traffic. And there is the Bay of Fundy, and the tides are going out. Let's go clam dig. All right, where are we here? We're looking. All right, I'm gonna take it out of autopilot. There is the buzzer. And we're gonna continue to join and downwind. I think the active is, well, we can do 27, I suppose. Let me ask. Truck Unicom, Foxtrot, Romeo Uniform. The shoot up, we're up. What's the active, Dave?
Okay, Delta 05.
Delta 05, okay, thanks. Davis 05. Okay. Join the mid downwind. And since the winds are favoring 05, why not?
It was a great flight.
Traffic, Foxtrot Romeo Uniform. It is now over the airfield, crossing 05 to join me downwind, land Debert.
It's showing right now about 14 to the left and 12 to the right. If you take it there for a quick pay your doors, that should be good for past flight. Welcome. And landing checks.
And flaps down. And 20. Half of the runway is unserviceable. You can see the axis. So we're gonna land way down where the lines are. And flaps 30. which makes it a short runway, but